UK shares bounced back early Tuesday amid signs that the Crimea crisis may diffuse on reports Russia had scaled back its military exercises near Ukraine. Natural resources companies were in the spotlight following the release of various earnings reports, but there were mixed fortunes in the sector. Gold producer Fresnillo, for instance, took a tumble at the start of trading after it revealed profit for the year down 69.5%. The group was hit by lower precious metals prices, decreased gold production at the Minera Penmont operations, and the loss generated by the silver stream re-evaluation. Glencore Xstrata, on the other hand, reported annual adjusted EBITDA up 17%, with strong results in the trading division. The natural resources company said it continues to see healthy demand growth in all its key commodities in 2014, underpinned by the long-term trend of urbanization in emerging markets and parts of the developed world returning to trend growth. And battle group Serco, meanwhile, reflected back on a difficult year when it issued several profit warnings. The outsourcing specialist said that in 2014 it faces above-average contract attrition, reduced volume of work in Australian immigration services, and lower-than-expected growth from new contracts awarded. Among small caps now, a raft of positive corporate news cheered investors, and there were hopes of a turnaround at Perform Group. The company, which snaps up the rights to highlights and live streams of sport and licenses them to media groups, saw its stock plunge almost 60% in December, but the shares were up today. In its full-year results, the company said it focused on meeting its revised targets for next year. Elsewhere, Rose Petroleum soared after agreeing a joint venture for its legacy copper assets, which will see Toronto-listed Lowell Copper fund exploration work. Lowell will initially earn a 25% stake in the TC Porphyry copper project in return for spending $250,000 on exploration. Permitting for a drill program is underway and it's planned to start in the second or third quarter of this year. Ncondezi Energy is also on the upside today after it received four bids from internationally recognized firms for the engineering, procurement and construction contract for its 300-megawatt Ncondezi power plant project. Ncondezi, which is developing an integrated thermal coal mine and power plant in the Tete province in Mozambique, will evaluate the bids and provide an update on the selection of the preferred bidder in the second quarter. Magnolia Petroleum was also witnessing share price gains today after it announced it has taken stakes in two new Oklahoma wells, meaning it now has interests in 205, more than three times the number it started with when the group listed on AIM in November 2011. And that's it for the main news today, Tuesday, the 4th of March.